Hi, everyone, and welcome to our Miami Film Festival Gems Q&A for Rosa's Wedding. I'm joined by the film's director, Isiar Boyayin. One of the things that I love about this film is just the idea. It's a very feminist and like female focused. Was that something that you guys really wanted to achieve with it?
Well, the thing is, this type of character, this women like Rosa, is a very feminine kind of profile because, I mean, it's centuries of the women being in the role of the carers. Sometimes you find men caring, no doubt of it, but it's very much expected from women. So I don't know, maybe in the States it's not as strong, but here families, there is always in the family that is expected to take care of the older.
Yeah.
Is expected to take care of the young ones, and it's usually a woman. Mm-hmm. So I think the theme of starting a new life is universal. Anyone can, at any point in your life, maybe the middle age, you can decide enough is enough, I want to take a turn to my life. That is universal. But I think that this kind of character, which has kind of left herself to the last and doesn't pay attention to herself and doesn't pay attention to her own needs, is very feminine.
Yes, it is. And also in the same vein as that, one of the things that really struck me when I was watching the film was the idea, was its commentary on marriage and the idea that marriage is sort of the way to legitimize your own life and your life choices. Even the characters in the film whose relationships are failing, they still have that sense of legitimacy in their life because they're married. Was that something you really wanted to communicate in the film?
Yes, I think there is a kind of, I think we should all go through some sort of, I think rituals are very good, and we don't have in our culture any ritual to take yourself on, because yeah. the person you're going to be with all your life is yourself. Mm-hmm. But we don't have any, we have maturity rituals, we have rituals for adolescents getting into adulthood, yeah. Or weddings, we have first communion, we have the Jewish celebrations, we have all sorts of celebrations of the person joining in society, and then but we don't have any celebration of ourselves joining in society,
right?
And we are
a celebration about being independent.
yeah, and it's like, okay, I'm gonna be with myself for the rest of my life, so I better take care of myself. So I think it's important, and actually so much unhappiness comes from when you don't take care of yourself. Mm-hmm. I think most of our mental problems and depressions and things is when you don't listen to yourself, when you're not in contact with yourself. So I think it's very important. I think it should be like first thing in primary school to love yourself. Before maths and before reading and writing probably is
who
I am. I like myself the way I am. I have my face, but I have my... So yes, there was a... I think that the solo wedding has lots of levels. That's the thing. It's a mad idea, but within it,
it works so well in the film.
it has lots of existential questions.
Yeah, what one scene I love is the scene of her bachelorette party the night before the wedding. the siblings are all drinking and dancing, and there's this really catchy song playing in the background that I couldn't get out of my head for days. Can you tell me a little bit about the music selection and how that kind of speaks to Rosa's character?
The music for that particular party was very tricky because we were wondering who plays the music. Whose iPhone is or whose mobile is. So it could be the girl, it could be Lydia, it could be Violeta, the sister, it could be Rosas. So in the end, talking with the sound woman, which is the sound engineer, which is a great professional and is a friend and she's a lot into music, she has suggested this Colombian group, which was less stereotypical as salsa. The salsa is being used so much. Mm-hmm. It's in Spanish, but it's in a funny Spanish because it's a Spanish. I mean, it's not our Spanish, it's Latin American Spanish, right. Colombian. So we thought it has a great rhythm, it's kind of modern, it's kind of electronic, but it's kind of so. And then it fitted in with the rest. The musician of the film is a woman again, is called Vanessa Garde, which I think has done a beautiful job of it's a music with lots of Mediterranean echoes and Mediterranean instruments. And we thought in the Italian films of the 50s and the 60s, the comedies, there is a musician called Nino Rota, which is a classic in this kind of comedy, kind of messy comedy family films from Italy. So we got inspiration in these kind of things.
Great. The music brings such a great energy to the film. I was actually just about to ask you about the end scene. The end scene is so much fun to watch. I mean, the whole movie is leading up to this crazy idea of marrying yourself, but it's so much fun to watch, but it also looks like it must have been so much fun to film. Can you tell me a little bit about what it was like on set that day?
At the end, you mean, or when?
Yes, filming the wedding scene on the beach.
The scene looks fun, but it was a little bit of a rush because we didn't have that much time to shoot it. It was so important, so many things going on there, so we have to rush it a bit. But still, it was very beautiful to shoot because the bows, Candela does, she does them very beautifully.
Her dress is
amazing. Then we have that band. Yeah, it's very emotional how she does it. And then we have the band there, which was a band from the village, lovely people playing that mambo. And But shoots are always, you're always kind of saving the day, you know, because the day before we have had a storm and then half of the beach was gone with the sea. So we had to shrink the guests all together because it wasn't enough space.
Right.
So, and then you are crossing your fingers for the rain not to come because you don't have a cover set. You don't have, that was the very last day of the whole shoot, the wedding. We left it for the last day, but then it looks chilly and it looks happy, but it was.
People are gonna love the movie so much. It's really just so fun and so sweet and so hopeful. I can't wait for them to see it. Thank you so much for joining us for this Q&A.
Thank you very much for having me, and hope the audience in Miami enjoy the film.